In this session, we are using the Excel sheet provided by HR manager Pinali and trying to understand their requirements. As a data analyst, it is critical for you to listen more than you talk in this particular stage of the project. This is the stage where you also keep the client completely engaged by asking them the right questions. Also, this is your opportunity to become their strategic partner rather than one-off solution provider. Ask questions to understand their short and long-term plans and align your solutions accordingly. Now, you might be wondering, where do I learn this skill of asking right questions? Don't worry, we are going to cover all of that in today's video.
So what I understand from the data is that you have just the current fiscal year, like your fiscal year, which is starting from April to June.
March. Yeah.
Okay. So you have this 3 months of data and you want to combine these three months of data together to see the insights, which you said, like you want to understand. So I saw your email. Can you please kind of explain me what insights you would like to see from this data?
Sure. So first of all, I want to understand the working preference of people, between work from home and work from office.
Okay.
Yeah. So okay. If they are taking frequent work from home either on Monday or the Friday, then what could be the reason behind that?
Okay. So basically you have this attendance key. So in that work from home is denoted as, okay.
WFH.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, and we also have half work from home, which means like people work from home for half a day. Okay.
Yes.
So we need to consider this and Okay.
Yeah.
And you said you want to understand the presence of people, like how much percentage of people are present on a given week or a given month. Basically attendance, right? Like attendance of the people. Okay.
Yes. And because sometimes it happens that if people have joined the office, but suddenly they are not feeling well and they are leaving and they said that I'll be working from home the rest day. So we have to figure out this thing.
Okay. So
also I understand. As an owner of Athletic, I also look at these insights and I have a frequent conversation with Pinali on this. Let's say if people are working from home, if their preference is Monday or Friday, it could be either towards the end or beginning of the week, or it could be in the middle of the week. So, so if we get some insights from that, then maybe when we are planning some team building activity or team lunch, we will do it on a day where majority of the people are present in the company.
Okay.
Right.
The other benefit of knowing this is, let's say if you go in a partial hybrid model where people work from home on 2 days, then they are available on 3 days, then we can do better capacity planning. We can have a few people coming in the office and we give laptop to everyone at Athletic. So we don't need to have so much rental space. We can do better utilization of the space and save our cost on infrastructure.
Okay, that makes sense.
All right.
And do you also want any particular insights from any other things here? Like, for example, maybe...
If people are taking sick leave, that... Yeah. We want to understand the reason, because it might be an indication of COVID, then we have to take some precautions, right? So
sorry, I was just taking notes. Yeah, please go ahead.
No, that's fine. So it can be better if we can get the insights, like the reason they are taking sick leave, so we can take better plans.
Okay, so you want to understand on a given day. If let's say 15% of your employees or 10% of your employees are taking sick leave, which is a clear indication that, you know, like something is not good, because it cannot be a coincidence if too many people take sick leave on the same day.
Exactly.
Okay.
And COVID is just a special situation, but we have seen often there are seasonal flus, there are chikungunya, like little pandemics, little epidemics where many people in the town are infected because of like dengue, you know. And if we can find the patterns, we can enable better sanitization or take special measures. I mean, we generally have good sanitization infrastructure in the company, but we can take special precautions, special measures.
Yeah.
I have seen here in US, in companies, they have doctors coming in. They give flu shots before fall season. So maybe we can do those kind of activities. If we have good insights on number of people being sick on given period of the time in a year.
Okay, great. Yeah, maybe the other reason is there is a cricket match or something like that. You never know.
If you can, if you can include that analytics, link it with cricket schedule, that would be pretty interesting analytics to watch for.
I know we have people with high integrity in our clique, so just kidding.
Yes.
All right. Yeah. So my first question is, like, ideally, Pinali, this should be, this should be available in a system, right? Because Excel is okay. We can do it in Excel. I can show you how to do it in Excel. But I know that this is what you explained in the email. You told that you are planning to migrate to a system, a new system.
Yes.
When that's going to happen?
I think by next month.
Okay. All right. So what the reason why I'm asking that question is that I can kind of create the database in a very similar pattern. That will match with your new system. So you don't have to make a lot of changes, because my intention is, like, whatever we are going to do now, you can do it on your own.
Exactly. I want to learn this stuff so I can do it my own. Yes. I don't need to ask you every time.
Yeah.
Right.
You can. I know this can become a very powerful tool for you once you learn how to crunch
data.
Not at a very advanced level that you can develop, gradually, but I think with sessions, like two or three sessions like this, and if you take some time to practice on your own, I'm pretty sure that you will start doing things on your own. This is something I've seen with people, that I work with, my friends. Once they learn the basics and they practice, they become more powerful in their work. Like I've known some warehouse managers, HR people as well, they start doing stuff on their own. So great. I'm going to open Power BI now and let's see how we can import this data. And so initially we're going to clean the data and understand, how we can shape the data for the insights that you want. So I'm going to do, it's I'm going to keep the insights that you want in the mind, and I'm going to build the database accordingly. So this is a database now, which is, even though it's coming from Excel, this is going to be a database. All right. So we'll start doing that.